In New York today, as world leaders met at the UN to address climate change. The one-day meeting comes after a rallying cry from people all over the world and here at home. Elise Martinez reports.
There's one issue that will define the contours of this century more dramatically than any other, and that is the urgent and growing threat of a changing climate.
President Obama addressed the United Nations General Assembly at Tuesday's summit on climate change, calling on all nations to cut carbon emissions across the globe immediately.
We can only succeed in combating climate change if we are joined in this effort by every nation, developed and developing alike. Nobody gets a pass.
The Environmental Defense Center in Santa Barbara is glad to see all the attention being placed on the environment.
We are excited to see this conversation taking place. Action needs to happen on a regional level, it needs to happen on a national level, and it needs to happen on a global level, and it needs to happen quickly.
Owen Bailey is the executive director of the EDC and says change starts here at home.
Here at the Environmental Defense Center, we're looking at future development. We need to make sure that all of our carbon emissions are disclosed up front and that those carbon emissions are fully mitigated.
Bailey and his children were among hundreds of thousands of people who marched in Ventura, Santa Barbara, and around the world Sunday, demanding solutions to climate change. As people continue to rally, Bailey hopes world leaders will finally come up with a concrete solution.
We don't have a second chance to get this wrong. So we need to be acting as individuals. We need to be holding our leaders accountable to take climate action.
In Santa Barbara, I'm Elise Martinez.
Today's summit was designed to lay the groundwork for a new global treaty to tackle climate change in 2015. The hope is to avoid the outcome of the last climate summit back in 2009, when world leaders left without signing a binding agreement. Coming